What's happening, YouTube? Josh Tedder here for 6 months later, and as always, October is looking to be a very busy month in the world of Google Home and Google Assistant. Now, last year and during the October event that Google held in the earlier part of the month, we saw the launch of the Google Home Max and Google Home Mini. And this October, there's a Google event on October 9th, and we're expecting new Google Home hardware to come out of this event as well. But before we get to the rumors on the new hardware, we've got some new great Google Assistant features to go over. So let's get started. This is 6 months later. Now, before we get into the features updates, a word of warning. Not all of the updates I'm about to talk about may have rolled out to your Google Assistant depending on where in the world you live. I'm currently living here in the United States and I use the US English version of the Google Assistant, but if you're in another part of the world that's not the United States, some of these features may not have rolled out to your Assistant if you're using Assistant in a different language or if you just live in a different country. So with that, let's go ahead and dive into the first features update, which is actually an update to a feature I talked about on our last features update video, which is scheduled routines. Now with scheduled routines, you can have a routine run during a certain time of day and you don't always have to use your voice to schedule the routine. This feature is great for your bedtime routine. You can now schedule that routine to take place during a certain time at night, or you can create an entirely new scheduled routine. Say for Halloween, you can have all of your Halloween decorations turn on at a specific time during the evening. To schedule a routine, go ahead and open your Google Home app, go to More Settings, Routines. Now, unfortunately, it doesn't seem like you can edit pre-existing routines you already may have and add a schedule to them. This only seems to work for creating new routines. You can give your commands and then add in a time or day for the routine to run. The rest of setting up the routine is just how it worked in our last features update video. So if you haven't checked that out, definitely go ahead and check out the features update 5 video for more information on how to set up a routine. Now for an update on home control. The Google Home devices now understand the context of interacting with your smart devices even more. If you tell Google to turn off the lights, it will now understand that you want the lights of the room that you are in to turn off and not just all the lights in your entire residence. In my experience, when you ask the Google Assistant to turn off the lights previously, it would often turn off the lights in your entire residence. Now, this isn't an issue if you live alone, but if you live with other people, it can be kind of annoying when the lights in your room suddenly turn off because your roommate over in his room decided to turn off the lights using Google. Thankfully, this update now fixes that annoyance. Now, if you still want to turn off all of your lights, just tell Google to turn off all lights. Next up, another update from our last features update video. The bilingual functionality for the Google Assistant has now launched. So bilingual families across the globe can now rejoice. You can now ask your Google Assistant through your Google Home devices a query in one language and then ask it another query in a different language. As long as both of those languages are supported by the Google Assistant, Google will be able to understand your query. Now you can effortlessly switch between languages in between your query as long as you still use the same trigger word, Google. Next up, the Google Assistant can now read out a more detailed news report thanks to its ability to leverage the newly revamped Google News service. If you haven't checked out Google News yet, I highly recommend it. It lets you focus on the news topics that you're interested in from all of your favorite sources and subscriptions in a beautifully simple design. For the expansion of the news feature with the Google Assistant, you can now ask Google to learn more about a specific news topic. For example, you can ask it, "What's the news on President Trump?" A lively topic, no doubt.
Here's the latest from Fox News. Trump's tax returns will be target of Democrats' probe if they win House in midterms. The mystery of President Trump's tax returns could finally come to an end if Democrats win control of at least one chamber of Congress following the midterm elections in November. Democratic lawmakers in the House are planning to use an obscure, almost 100-year-old tax statute that permits the chairman of Congress's tax committees to look at anyone's returns to get to the bottom of Trump's finances and possibly make public the information that the president has kept guarded since the 2016 election. There were two other articles, which I've sent to your phone. Do you want me to read the first one?
Yes.
Sure. CNN has this update.
Or you can ask it something completely different, like, what's the latest news on black holes?
This is the latest from Forbes. Active supermassive black holes may have quashed life's emergence. Bruce Dorminey, contributor, opinions expressed by Forbes contributors are their own. Active galactic nuclei, AGNs, powered by supermassive black holes at the centers of most young galaxies, may have put the quash on life's evolution, says one new study. That's all I have for now. You can find a link to the full text on your phone.
Notice that Google will not only give you an update about a specific topic, but it will give you the latest news stories. It will offer to send you the stories to your phone, as well as ask if you want to read the stories out loud, which is a pretty impressive feature. If you've been bogged down by the day's news, as is often the case here in the United States, well, Google has a feature for that as well. Just ask Google to tell me something good, and it'll give you a positive news story to make you feel better about the world. At least for a minute.
From Philly.com, Philadelphia Media Network. What started as a small exchange program between Temple University and a local corrections facility has become an international model. The Inside Out exchange program engages university students and gives inmates educational opportunities. 30,000 students have participated in the program, half of them prisoners. Is it okay if I send that to your phone?
Yes.
Okay, go ahead and check, and I'll talk to you there.
The stories are selected and summarized by the nonpartisan, nonprofit Solutions Journalism Network, according to TechCrunch, who describes the group as an organization that helps train journalists to better cover how people are responding to problems and how those actions can have positive results. The assistant will even go a step further for you if you have a Google Assistant smart display. It will play relevant YouTube videos to the news topic you asked about on the smart display. Now, speaking of smart displays, you may be wondering why I haven't personally bought one or done a review of one on the channel. And that's simply because I decided to hold off on buying a smart display like the Lenovo version because I had a feeling that Google was going to do their own made by Google smart display. And it looks like that Google will be announcing a smart display made and designed by Google at their October 9th event coming up, and it's rumored to be called the Google Home Hub. The Google Hub is rumored to be Google's own rival to the Amazon Echo Show, and will be one more device that aligns to Google's smart display strategy for its Google Assistant, except this smart display is designed and made by Google. Now, it's rumored to have a 7-inch display, but it's unclear whether or not there will be a larger variant of the new Google smart display, like we have with Lenovo's smart display, which also comes in a 10-inch variant. We'll have to wait and see as well on price and some of the other specs when Google's rumored to announce this device at their October 9th event. Now, be sure to stay tuned to the channel right after that event. I'll be doing a reaction video a couple of days with my thoughts on everything that Google announced, as well as you can be sure if they do announce any new Google Home hardware, I'll have that on the channel as soon as I can get my hands on it for a first look video, and of course, later on down the road, a 6 months later review. Well, that's it for our Google Home Features Update video. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel to see more Google and Google Home videos like this one. Also, you can read a version of this video, as well as thought pieces, reviews, on our new website, 6-months-later.com. So make sure to check that out. And lastly, let me know what you thought of the video, if you're excited for what Google is rumored to unveil at their October 9th event. And let me know also if you think I've missed any features that they have recently put out for the Google Home devices. Well, until next time, thanks again so much for watching. I'm Josh Tedder for 6 Months Later.